Hello, this is Johnny, and in this video I'm gonna import a 3D animated character from Blender to Godot. As you can see, I already have a character with bunch of animations in Blender. The looped animations have minus looped at the end of the name so that they're marked as looped animation when they're imported in Godot. I also created a new project in Godot, and I'm gonna create a new folder called player. This is where we're gonna import our player 3D model. We're gonna use the GLTF export for this model as I have found it to give the best results. If you don't see the GLTF export in the export menu, you can enable it in preferences by going to add-on and searching GLTF. So now I'm just gonna select everything I want to export, go to file, export, GLTF, and right here I'm gonna enable remember export settings and go to include and enable selected object, which is actually disabled by default. As I have other steps like lights and cameras in this Blender file, if I don't enable this option, Blender is gonna export everything. So that's why I'm gonna need this enabled. If you have any modifiers in your model like mirror modifier, you might wanna check this option called apply modifiers. All the other options are pretty much like how I want. But still, I'm just gonna show you how they are for me. So I'm gonna select my target directory, which is the player folder inside my project, and I'm gonna press export. It's gonna take a few seconds depending on your machine. The only weird thing is, there's nothing to indicate the progress of the export. Blender just literally stops responding while it's exporting, then it comes back to normal after it's done. I don't know if everyone has this issue, or if this is just a bug, or that's how it's meant to be. If you know this, please let me know in the comments. So now Godot is going to import that automatically. Now I'm going to open the GLB file and everything seems to be okay. It also imported the animations correctly. So I'm just going to save this as a TSCN file. Now keep in mind that this is not actually a player object, but only the 3D model of our player. I'm gonna create a new scene, which is going to be a kinematic body, and this one's going to be the player object. I'm gonna add a special node for the 3D model, and I'm gonna rename it as mesh. Then I'm gonna drag and drop our player model on this mesh node. Also, I'm gonna create a collision shape for the player, which is going to be of a cylinder shaped. I'm gonna rescale this collision shape, and then I'm gonna save this scene. So now our character is good to go.